Ricky Langley is a man who, in 1992 in Louisiana, molested children and murdered a 6-year-old boy named Jeremy Guillory. He had been previously convicted of child abuse, of molestation, but had been let out of prison and then met this little boy and killed him. Ricky, after the murder, Ricky Langley was on death row in Louisiana. He faced the death penalty. And I am very opposed to the death penalty. And I followed my beliefs to law school at Harvard, where I knew that what I wanted to do was fight the death penalty. And so my first chance, I took a job with a law firm that was helping to defend Ricky Langley. And, you know, there I was, full of everything I believed in, really wanting to fight the death penalty. But when I encountered Ricky's case by watching a confession videotape that he had made, and I listened to him describe molesting children, and I listened to him describe the pleasure he took in killing Jeremy Guillory, I was just overcome by a feeling of horror. I wanted Ricky Langley to die. And the very next thing that happened, which really shocked me and stayed with me, was that I learned that the mother of Jeremy Guillory, Lorelei Guillory, had testified for Ricky Langley at the trial. She had tried to keep him alive. She tried to keep the state of Louisiana from executing him. And so that kind of set off this big collision inside me. Because how had she been able to do that when I couldn't? What was there in the story that I didn't understand? And to another extent, or even to a larger extent, I think, the question that formed inside me was, is who we are determined by our past, or is who we are determined by what we believe? And I was haunted by that question for many years. And 10 years later, I returned to Louisiana and began to look into the case, investigate it. And that's how L'Empreint came to be. You know, I tried really hard not to. I was actually writing fiction. I went to graduate school to write fiction. And I would be working on this fiction, and the color blue would come in, or a BB gun would show up. And anyone who's read the book knows that these images are things that recur in the book. But at the time, what I felt was, oh, I'm being haunted by that case. I remember these details. They are from that case. They are from this man killing this little boy. And I felt like I remembered everything about the case, everything about the story, but in those moments, I couldn't remember Ricky Langley's name. For years, in fact, I would look up the files, I would look up the records from the case, and yet, as soon as I put them down, I couldn't remember who had done the murder. And I knew that was weird, right? Because I was swimming in the details, and yet I had this perfect little excision, this perfect little absence. And there's only one other moment like that in my life. And it has to do with my grandfather. And so I realized that these things were linked for me, and that I was thinking so much about the Langley case, about Ricky's murder, the murder he committed, in some ways because I was trying to understand something about my own past, about my own life. And I think that was why it became important. It just felt like I had to write it. I certainly tried to write many other things along the way. And I did. I would write short pieces and finish them. But I always kept coming back to this book. I always kept thinking, oh, there's something there that I need to put into words.